Welcome to This Uncommon View. It's great to have you here. What I want to show you right now is some hot business opportunities for the next 10 years. Wouldn't it be great if you could see into the future and know where A, money was going to be spent, and then B, what products, services could be created to meet that demand? Wouldn't that be awesome? Well, you actually can. There is so much data around these days, so many articles on the internet, so many reporters getting it right about the future and in terms of where technology is going, because technology is driving everything. This is the technology era, right, where it drives everything and it's only getting more and more powerful. So what I thought I'd give you in this Uncommon View is an insight into some of the opportunities coming your way, and then what I'll do is I'll interpret some of those opportunities and turn them into your language so that you can understand what you could do from your perspective for that market. Okay, I'm going to go live to the internet with a recent article, okay, from Colorado Biz. And when I read these things, the ideas just go off in my head about the opportunity that is available to you, all right? So let me show you how I would approach the information. You might just normally maybe read this information and think, oh, it's interesting. I read it and I go, oh my goodness, there's this business, that business, that business, this business. So let me show you what I see, okay? So the actual topic of this article is 72 stunning things that will be common in 10 years. So that's good, and it's all about technology. And there's a little bit of text here leading up to the fact that, you know, the iPhone came out in 2007. We didn't have smartphones with mobile apps, decent cameras and for video and for photographs on our phones. It just wasn't even around. 2007, so less than, 10 years ago, this just wasn't even available. And now, none of the apps that are huge today, huge money spinners, like things like Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, Snapchat, weren't even around. So as apps, they just were not there. So now they are apps. There's this huge field now of business which is available to you, business opportunities which are available to you, which weren't there before. So what you want to do with this lesson is now see another 10 years into the future. If we take 10 years, if we rewind 10 years, could you have seen the possible opportunities? They'd be hard to see. However, now because of how we see technology is evolving, now they're much easier to see, okay? So we're saying goodbye to all the old technology, the fax machines and radios and things like that, because it's all changing dramatically. So then what's happening instead? Well, you may have heard of things like 3D printing. Now, 3D printing right now, at this very moment, you're not getting anything done via 3D printing. All right, you don't have a 3D printer in your home office. You just don't have it. But that is all going to change, because right now, their technology is speeding up, okay, and it's getting so powerful that you haven't heard about it yet, and it certainly hasn't reached your own office, your own space, but it's coming. And so things like this, like here's some things over the next 10 years which will be commonplace. And the one I like the most here is the 3D printed replacement teeth. So you go to the dentist, and instead of the normal process of having the teeth taken out perhaps, or a drill, in cleaning up the actual decay in the tooth, this new tooth would be printed straight onto your existing gum and or tooth structure. All right, amazing stuff. All printed inside your mouth. So less time. Everything's really, really fast in the future. Everything's really fast. Less time waiting around. Things like this where you could print custom designed clothing at home. So A, you can print it for yourself, but also you could start a shop and start selling your own clothing. But more importantly, you could be the provider of designs. You can be the provider of the materials. You can be the provider of the ideas of what people could actually print at home. Because A, it's great to have technology. B, how do you know what to actually do with the technology? Most people don't. It's like when the computer was invented, the person who made the most money was the person who created the software for the computer. So not the hardware, but the software. So in that same instance, you can be the software for the hardware of the idea. So you can create the, give the materials, give ideas for the end product. Is that making sense? Okay, that's something that's coming our way. Expectant mothers will request 3D printed models of their unborn baby. So instead of getting a scan or a 3D photo, now it could be an actual 3D doll, a 3D model of the actual baby. Wouldn't that be awesome? Something which a lot of mothers would like to keep for the future, all right? You have photographs when the baby is born. What about the photographs or models of the baby before it's born, you know? So lots of stuff there, right? Then as we progress down into virtual reality, augmented reality, this is pretty cool. You're going to see a lot of theme parks changing. So instead of having physical rides, which are hard to change, like roller coasters are hard to change, once you've built the structure, it's there for a long time. But that'll all change with a mix between virtual reality rides mixed with physical things. So it's happening right now in some parks in America where you're ushered into a big room with your augmented reality and virtual reality goggles, and the movie plays for you to watch, right? But you move around a physical room, and the game itself shows you where to go and where not to go, so it stops you from moving and hitting the wall. Things like that. It's all coming, right? Something else I want to show you here, too. The drones area, the drones business. Maybe you have a drone, heard of a drone, seen drone. The drones being, in this instance, like these four-propellered planes, right? Probably a bad description, but it's got four propellers on it, and it has a massive lift, massive maneuverability, and user control via a little device, right? So drones are now becoming very popular. So what does it represent for you? It represents opportunities. Like I see this, like fireworks. I agree with the article, right? Fireworks dropped from the drone. So it could change the way fireworks are presented. And so if you could be in the business of providing that, A, the drones or the software which controls the drones, or you could be the person who actually rents the drones to the fireworks company, things like that. You could be, here's another one, banner-pulling drones. I think this is good, banner-pulling drones. Right now you might see planes occasionally flying around and they'd be carrying a banner behind them with an advertisement. Well, what if you could get three drones and each would drop a banner, all right? And you control those three drones and companies pay you to come and stand or fly the drones outside their business so that the drones could go above the business and point to the business. There'd be an offer here, a big arrow there, then another offer there. But this would be something which you could have a business which is up and running like that. There'd be so many business owners wanting to pay you to stand out more, right? It's a brilliant opportunity. And so you could, and it'd be cheaper too than hiring a helicopter, hiring a plane. This would be an absolutely brilliant idea if you're interested, be able to do that, right? What else? You can send random stuff to random people and video their reactions. So the actual drones could have a camera on the front and you could be in the business of pranking people or of delivering gifts to people for other people so that you could videotape the person's face when they get the gift and send it to the person who sent it. Wouldn't that be cool? Amazing stuff, right? What else we got? We got electric cars are obviously coming our way. Electric cars. So this is great. It means less people will be driving, more people on the roads, of course, but in groups more often than not, but less people will be actually doing the driving, which means they have idle time. What could you provide people who actually have the idle time in their cars through through their apps, through computers, through software, that could help them get the most out of their time? All right, so things like what could you do? Like you can actually maybe work on technology which charges. So if while in the car, they can actually charge their device, but could they charge their device quicker than normal? Is there a way of upping the charge rate of phones, of software, of computers, that everything charges fast? So while they're in the car, they could be working, but their computer, their phone is charging super quick. You're always gonna try and find what's the most unique way of looking at something, right? Very, very cool. But entertainment's going to be a big thing. How can people be entertained while in their car? You might think, well, it's just going to be on their phone, watch something, but is there more to that? Is there more that you can do? Is there a way of actually entertaining people about the ride, the destination they're going to? Can they be actually helped to communicate with the destination they're going to? So if they're going to a restaurant in an electric car, that may be actually controlled by a robot or artificial intelligence, is a way they can communicate with the restaurant they're going to so the restaurant knows exactly when they're going to turn up. Can they pre-order meals by the time they get there? They walk in, the meal's ready. Software like this would be invaluable in the future when it comes to things like that, right? So it's just the most amazing thing. What do we see here? Print and PIN payment systems that use a biometric mark, okay? So what's happening there is that your PIN numbers will go and suddenly you'll just use your finger at the very least, right? And this will pay for things. So software is going to be needed for this. Software on a very basic scale, like there'll be high-tech software and technology that the big companies will use, but what about your average small business owner? you can help them adapt this technology to their business. Like when this technology comes in, they won't have the education on how to use the technology. So by having a fingerprint, how could you help them understand the customer more? So for instance, If a small business like your service station, hairdresser, maybe a restaurant was able to get fingerprint technology happening in their business, what could they could do is they could actually have all their customers perhaps. Oh, my microphone's just fallen off. I want you to hear what I'm saying. There we go. But if someone comes into their store, their shop, then they could somehow have them give their fingerprint again. And as soon as they do that, then because it's unique, they know that you have arrived. And they could have a pre-planned, pre-programmed set of bonuses for you, gifts for you, treatment for you, service for you, that you don't know about as a customer, but they do. And as soon as you scan your finger, bang, that service starts to be implemented at once. And what happens is the customer gets so much better service. Does this make sense to you, right? This personalization, this uniqueness of being able to know who's arriving in your business will be huge, because right now it's not possible. A person walks into a restaurant, a person walks into a store, and the business owner doesn't generally know a whole lot about them. They may recognize them, great, but they don't generally know a whole lot about them. So what could you do to help them implement these systems? And you don't need to be a software programmer, you just need to have the ideas. You can just help them implement the idea so that once they scan their finger, right, they can become a part of actually entering the stores, just putting your finger on there. Then you're gonna come up with ideas like, what could you do for customers? Be the idea generator of creating systems for when a customer comes in a third time, a tenth time. What stuff can you do for them? What stuff can you give them? If you're really smart, let's say we take a restaurant as an example. When I come there for my 10th visit, a little signal should go off and say, guess what, you're now earning a prize. Thank you so much for coming into this restaurant. We want to give you a massive gift, a big surprise gift. And you bring it to their table, they open it up and it tells them, you've now got $50 to spend at XYZ store, a $30 voucher at ABC store. All these little gifts all thrown in that other stores can now all come together to give gifts to that customer, so then that customer goes to spend money in their store. All right, there are so many opportunities here, and it's so exciting about what is coming. All right, so we've got health technology coming our way, massive changes in health technology, and that's going to be a big one. Now, health is obviously a harder area to get into, because if you're not health related or have any specialty in that area, it's hard to get into the health area, but so many things you can do. Let's look at some other ideas. Artificial intelligence is one of my favorite topics. It's so exciting, but so scary at the same time. So what if you could have an artificial intelligence, a robot software, actually tell everybody's biography? Like, you know, you've probably heard the saying that everybody has their own book inside them, right? So then, what if that was true? The problem is, most people don't know how to write a book, and they don't think their life's that interesting. Well, what if their life could be put into a biography by the artificial intelligence? What if the artificial intelligence, let's say call it a robot for now, could actually ask somebody questions, ask them just a few questions, and they answer verbally. The recording is taken into the system, transcribed, and then it's actually put into a book. Now, it doesn't have to be a 300-page book. It could be like a 10-page book, a 30-page book. And could also insert photographs that they can take. The software could take it from Facebook, photographs from Facebook, to give more depth, more warmth to the book, all right? So just questions being asked, questions being answered, creates the actual book. It works. It comes into a transcription. So what if you then were the person who had the software that did that? What if you're able to go to a programmer right now and tell them that idea and say, I want this to happen, can you make it happen? They'll quote you on how much it'll take to make that happen, but that would be a $1 million idea. Because all someone has to do is go to your website, answer a few questions, and bingo, within an hour, within maybe 24 hours, their biography is ready and sent to them as a PDF document with photographs and all their quotes, all the interesting stories all put into the one book. Wouldn't that be cool? All right, so when you look at these lists, you know, see them for what they really are. It's interesting information, but really think about the opportunity that's available to you over the next 10 years. It is just beyond exciting. So I hope that helps you a little bit in trying to see into the future and how my brain works in seeing opportunities, and maybe you can do it too, all right? So my name is Brett McFall. This has been my uncommon view. I'd love to hear your view. What is it? Talk to me. I'll see you soon.